Welcome to CrossGems. In this video, we will see how to use the Pave Prongs, and the Azzure Cutters, creating a ring using a few tools that we hope you will find useful. If you like this kind of videos, you can subscribe so we can keep creating 3D design content. Now, let's design. Let's start by creating a signet ring. Select the size 7.5 and raise the table to 1.2. Confirm, and we will draw the curve that will serve as a separator of the ring. Select the top viewport and change the display to wireframe. Open the curve tool, and with the grid snap and osnap activated, select these points on the grid, and then press enter. Returning to the perspective, as we can see, we have a spiral curve. Let's put all the points on the Z axis. Go to transforms, set points, and check the Z axis. We accept, lower the curve, press the blue ball of the gumball to extrude up the curve. We select all to create an intersection on the curves tool. We can hide it since we will not use it anymore. This way we have our curves drawn into the ring. As we can see, there is a singularity at the top that does not finish the curve. So we hide the ring, go to curves, select blend curves, and select the curve to close it. Now, what we will do is to join it. We already have the curve, and we are only interested in the back part, so we are going to cut it with the command break. This works like scissors. Select point A and the point B. Left click to repeat the last command and cut the bottom part. Now, what we'll do is to obtain the curve of the edge of the ring with the command duplicate edge. Select the four edges and press enter. We are going to join them and accept. We go to the command metal on curve to create the surface on the rail created. We put the size 0.8 and the profile 0. In options, we enable center on the curve. Accept, and we duplicate it to select the second remaining curves to adapt it to our edge. When we get it, confirm. Select the surface to create a mirror, and accept. We will use the hollow ring tool to empty the ring. We select 360 degrees, and accept. Now we make a Boolean difference with the four surfaces created. We select the four, and remember to disable delete input. The ring is ready. Let's create the gems. Select the size 3.8, and in position, we are going to select the top side of the ring. We confirm, and we are going to select the gem, and go to mirror and select diagonal mirror. Now we'll create the bezel. Select both gems, go to wireframe mode to see the bezel through the ring, and reduce the depth and shape to adapt it. Once the bezel is finished, we'll create the gem cutter. Select both gems and make the cut bigger than the bezel. Once we make the boolean to extract the part of the ring, no part should be left over. Confirm, and let's create the boolean difference of the ring, with the gem cutters and the bezels. Again, remember to disable the delete input, or the bezels will be deleted. we are going to create the pave in a part of the signet ring to later mirror the prongs and the gems. We can modify the number of the gems and the size of the gems that will be generated when we click on refresh. We are going to add the missing gem in this part and reduce the margin with the border. As we can see, the pavé shows the size of the gems and the distance between them. If we manage to lock the gems in this way, they will remain fixed in position while we can move them around the ring. We can add new gems, change their sizes, and move them to fit the surface. When the pave is finished, we confirm. Now, we are going to make the gem cutters. We select gem cutters, and we are going to select the pave. We are going to remove all the depth because now we will make the Azzure cutter. We will switch to wireframe mode to see the cutter better. We will modify the stone seed taper and the depth until it is well adjusted. Once ready, we will select the pave, and we will create a diagonal mirror. We confirm, and we'll do the same with the gem cutters. Now, let's create the Azure cutters. Select the pave, and the surface, select the inner surface of the ring, where the cuts will go. This may take some time. Once we have it, confirm. We can hide the cutters because we are going to create the pave prongs. In gem settings, select pave prongs. And we are going to select only one group of pave, because later we are going to do a mirror. We adapt the margin so that they look as good as possible. Then we will make the lower prongs for rendering. As we did with the gems, we can add prongs, remove and resize them, as you will see in the preview. When we have it ready, we can confirm. We select the prongs, and we are going to create a mirror. Select mirror diagonal and confirm. We show the cutters we had hidden to make the Boolean difference. As object A, we select the ring, and as object B, we select the Azzure Cutters. We check that everything is okay, and then we confirm. Finally, we'll go to Solids, and we'll make a Boolean difference. Select the ring, and press Enter. Now select the Gem Cutters, and press Enter again. As the delete input was set to no, the cutters remain, so let's hide them. We changed the display mode to CrossGems, so now all we have to do is change the materials. We go to the materials panel, and from the material selector, we select all the metals, and we select silver. We change to render view, and we'll change the grounds to have a look of the ring. We change the material of the gems to diamond black, and we select ray traced mode, so the ring is finished. Thanks for watching. If you find it useful, don't forget to subscribe. You can find us on Instagram, Facebook, and other social networks. See you in the next chapter.